Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Learn Commerce with Namita. I am Namita Mane. Today let us discuss dissolution of a partnership firm under Indian Partnership Act 1932. So this is the part 4 of topic Indian Partnership Act 1932. Already on my YouTube channel in the playlist of M-Law, you will find Indian Partnership Act 3 videos already which I have uploaded. Part 1 is about meaning, definition of partnership and partners. Part 3 is about types of partnership and types of partners. Part 3 is rights and duties of partner. And today is part 4 topic, that is dissolution of partnership firm. So all the links you will find in the description box. So do check the description box for the for all the videos. So without wasting time, let us move to the today's topic, that is dissolution of partnership firm. So what is dissolution of partnership firm under Indian Partnership Act 1932? We are going to discuss in this lecture. So first we'll see dissolution of firm. What do you mean by the word dissolution? Okay, so dissolution means discontinue or breaking the firm or bringing the firm to the end. Okay, dissolution means discontinue of a particular business, discontinue of the particular partnership relation under firm. Okay, so according to the section 39 of Indian Partnership Act 1932, dissolution of firm means, what is dissolution of firm is defined under section 39 of the act. So dissolution of the firm means the dissolution of partnership. Okay, dissolution of partnership between all the partners. Okay, dissolution of partnership is important to dissolve the firm. So the dissolution of partnership between all the partners of a firm is called dissolution of firm. Now what is dissolution of partnership? Try to understand what is dissolution of partnership. What is dissolution of partnership? So, and difference between means difference between dissolution of partnership and dissolution of the firm. First, I will explain you the dissolution of partnership. So dissolution of partnership means, suppose, okay, with an example I will explain you what is dissolution of partnership. Suppose there are three partners A, B and C. Okay, there are three partners A, B and C, and altogether they are called as partnership. Now suppose amongst these three partner, one partner, that is A, partner A retires or he dies. Okay, so in that case then it is dissolution of partnership, means three partners and one partner is retired or he is died, then in that case it is dissolution of partnership, because both the, means suppose if A moves out from the partnership, B and C can move their firm. Okay, they can carry their business. Okay, so if three partners are there and amongst these three partners, one partner retires or he goes out of the firm or he dies, then the remaining two partners can carry the business. Okay, because two partners are still in the partnership. So remaining two partners means B and C can carry their business. They can carry their firm. Clear. So if one partner is dissolved, or if one partner discontinue the partnership, or if one partner dies, then in that case that means it is dissolution of partnership. Okay, now what is dissolution of firm? Means the dissolution of partnership between all the partners. Okay, between all the partners, see the word all the partners are there, means dissolution of partnership means if three partners are there, one partner dies or retires and remaining three partners can carry the business. Okay, that is dissolution of partnership. Now suppose all the three partners, including partner A, okay, partner A, B and C, okay, all the three partners decide to discontinue the business, then it is called as dissolution of the firm. When all the partners of the partnership, means all the partnership should dissolve completely, then only it is called as dissolution of the firm. Clear? So it is important, whenever there is dissolution of a firm, it is important that the relationship between all the partners should discontinue. Okay, so dissolution of partnership firm is a process. Okay, it is a process in which the relationship between partners of the firm is dissolved or terminated. That means discontinue, break, or coming to the end. Clear? Dissolution means coming to the end or terminated or discontinue. Now if a relationship, okay, if the relationship between all the partners, if the relationship between all the partners of the firm, if the relationship between all the partners of the firm is dissolved, means if it is discontinued, then it is known as a dissolution of a firm. Means A and B, A, B, C are partnership, are partners. If these three partners, okay, if these three partners A, B and C decide to dissolve, okay, then it is called as dissolution of the firm. If suppose only C says that, if C says I don't want to continue the partnership, or if C retires or dies and remaining two partners are still in the partnership, then in that case it is called as dissolution of partnership. So if you want to dissolve the firm, then the relationship of all the partners should dissolve. Okay, then it means what? It means it discharge the contract. Discharge means bringing the contract between the partnership are end, okay, which was created amongst the partners. So it discharge the contract means it brings the contract to the end which was created amongst the partners. Now suppose whatever the partners entered into the contract, okay, for some purpose they had entered, and their purpose is completed, their obligation, their rights and duties is completed, that means it is discharge. Okay, so once the obligations and rights are completed, then it can be, the partnership firm can be dissolved. Okay, so in short, dissolution of the firm means discontinue of the business, and to discontinue of the business, all the partners of the firm's agreement should be there. Okay, the relationship between all the partners of the firm is dissolved. It is known as dissolution of the firm. So I hope you have understood what is the meaning of dissolution of a firm. Now we will see various modes or various types of dissolution, how the partnership comes to the end, in which type the partnership can come to the end, means in which type the business of partnership can come to the end. So we'll see in the next slide. So modes of dissolution means various methods of dissolution. Now there are various methods of dissolution, like partnership dissolution of firm can be done by agreement, can be done by compulsory dissolution, it can be done by court orders also. So we will see one by one. So all the modes means various methods of dissolutions are given in the section 40, 41, 42, 43, 44. Okay. So first we will see dissolution by agreement. So till now, I hope all the students have understood what is dissolution. Okay. Dissolution is nothing but discontinue of a particular work or particular firm, particular business, discontinue of the particular partnership also. So dissolution by agreement, it is given in the section 40 that a firm, okay, a firm may be dissolved, a firm may be discontinued with the consent of all the partners. Okay, so dissolution by agreement, agreement means by mutual agreement. If suppose in a particular firm, if all the partners, okay, if all the partners decide to close their partnership or close their firm, then by the mutual understanding, by mutual agreement amongst all the partners, then the firm can be dissolved. Okay, a firm may be dissolved with the consent of all the partners. Consent means by the agreement of all the partnership, of all the partners, or in accordance with a contract between the partners. Now suppose if the contract between the partner was only for 1 year, okay, so 1 year is completed, so by all the mutual agreements amongst all the partners, the partnership can be disclosed. Okay, so firm can be disclosed by the agreement of all the partners, and the agreement should be mutual agreement. Okay, so the partnership firm can be dissolved by the agreement also. Now next is compulsory dissolution. Compulsory dissolution according to the section 41. Now a firm is compulsory, okay, a firm is compulsory dissolved, okay, by the happening, by what way the firm is dissolved. A firm is dissolved compulsory by the happening, okay, by the happening of any event which makes it unlawful, okay, which makes it unlawful for the business of the firm to be carried on, or for the partners to carry it on in partnership. Okay, so if a firm can be completely dissolved by compulsory, compulsory dissolved by the happening of any event, and that event is unlawful, okay, unlawful for the business to carry on or to carry for the partners also. Now suppose there are three partners ABC. Out of these three partners, one partner goes in the agreement, or he deals with the gambling purpose. Okay, he meets with the narcotics business. Okay, so this is unlawful. Dealing with drugs is unlawful. So it is the firm in that case, because of one partner, the other partners are suffering. So the other partners can go for the compulsory dissolution also. Okay, so unlawful things cannot make it possible to work any partnership. Okay, next dissolution of partnership firm, dissolution of partnership firm on the happening of certain contingencies under section 42. So under section 42 also the partnership can dissolve on the happening of certain contingencies. Means what? Some situation or some things which are not in the hands of partners. Okay, that means the things which are not in control of partner can dissolve the partnership firm. Now this are subject, okay, the things which are not in the hands of partners or which cannot be controlled, so they are subject to contract between the partners, a firm is dissolved. Okay, so dissolution of a partnership firm on the happening of certain contingencies, so subject to the contract between the partners, a firm is dissolved. Okay, subject to the contract between the partner, a firm can be dissolved. So what are those subjects? Okay, these are the subjects. Okay, according to this subject, the partnership can be dissolved. Now first is where the firm is constituted for a fixed period. Okay, on the expiry of that term, the partnership can be dissolved. Now the firm, suppose the partnership is made for 5 years. Okay, so once the 5 year is completed, the partnership will be dissolved. Okay, so it is for the when the firm is constituted, means when the firm is formed only for a fixed period of time. For example, 5 years. So on the expiry of 5 years, the partnership can be dissolved. Okay, so if suppose still after 5 years the partner wants to continue the partnership, then they have to form a new contract or new agreement. Okay, next is when the firm is constituted to carry out one or more adventurous or undertaking. Okay, now when the firm is constituted, now when the partnership is constituted to carry some particular project, okay, or some particular undertaking, and once the project is completed, the partnership is dissolved. Now in earlier lecture, in part 2, I have explained you that in the types of partnership, like particular partnership, then adventure partnership, I have given you example in that lecture. So I will give the same example. Now suppose the partnership between ABC was formed to build one residency, okay, residency building, and once this residency building is ready, the partnership will come to an end. Okay, so ABC they came together in the partnership only to construct this the residency society. Okay, and once the project of this residency society is completed, so ABC partnership will be dissolved. Okay, so by the completion thereof, means once the project is completed, the partnership will be dissolved. Okay, so see, by these, all these conditions are subject to the contract between the partners. Okay, and dissolution firm on the happening of certain conditions, means once the project, certain conditions means happening, the project is completed, the partnership is ended. Okay, or by the death of the partner, by the death of a partner. Yeah, there is one mistake. Okay, so dissolution of partnership firm can happen by the death of any one partner. Okay, or by the adjudication of the partner as an insolvent. Adjudication of the partner as an insolvent. Okay, if suppose in the partnership, if one partner is an insolvent person, then the partnership can come to an end. Okay, next are dissolution by notice. It is according to section 43. So partnership can come to an end by giving one notice. Okay, so when the partnership is at will, okay, when the partnership is at will, means when the part in the type of partnership, there is partnership at will, that is the partnership has formed and there is no duration, time limit is not given. Okay, so it becomes partnership at will. Now where the partnership is at will, okay, so the firm may be dissolved. Okay, if the partnership is at will, partnership at will means there is no duration of the time, of the means there is no time limit given in the partnership. So suppose the partnership at fixed means, if it is given the fixed time period is given, then it becomes partnership at fixed, means for 5 years the partnership is there, so that is fixed time limit is given. If there is no time limit mentioned in the partnership, then it becomes partnership at will. Okay, then it becomes partnership at will. Now suppose if the partnership is at will, the firm may be dissolved. Okay, how the firm will be dissolved if the partnership is at will? By any partner. Okay, by any partner means 3 partners, 4 partners are there in the partnership, then any one partner can give, okay, by any partner, by giving notice in writing, okay, to all other partners of his intention to disclose the firm. So if amongst the four partner, if one partner gives in writing to all the other partners, okay, to all other partners of his intention, what is the intention of that partner? To dissolve the firm, means to dissolve, to discontinue the firm. So in that case, the partnership can be dissolved. If the date is mentioned, okay, if the partner in the notice, if he has mentioned the date, okay, then the firm is dissolved as from the date mentioned in the notice, okay. If the date is mentioned in the notice which the partner is giving to the other partner to disclose the firm, then the firm is disclosed from that day, okay, from that date. If there is no date mentioned, okay, in the notice, if there is no date mentioned, then in that case, the partner has to communicate the notice to other partners, okay. Then communication, when the partner communicate to the other partner of the dissolution, then from that day, the partnership is ended, okay. Clear? So note, the dissolution of partnership can happen by notice also. Next is dissolution by court. Okay, dissolution of by court. Now dissolution by mutual agreement, dissolution by notice, compulsory dissolution, then dissolution of partnership on the happening of certain coincidence. The partnership can be dissolved. Now there are some cases where the partnership can be dissolved by the order of court, okay. So the dissolution of court is given in the section 44 of the Indian Partnership Act 1932. So court may at the suit of the partner, means even the partners can go to the court to dissolve the partnership, okay. So if court finds that the partnership is not working properly, court may give the order. Or if partners find that the partners with whom they are working, they are not suitable, then the partners can apply to the court to dissolve the firm, okay. So at the suit of the partners dissolves a firm on any of the following ground, okay. Means there are some cases, there are some points, if those in this point the partners can go to the court and they can dissolve that, they can discontinue the partnership by the order of court. So first means on the following of the circumstances or the situation, the partnership can come to the end. So first is partner becomes insane or unsound mind. Okay, insane or unsound mind means if he is not mentally physical, insane means stupid. Unsound mind means he is not in the situation or he is not mentally fit to in the partnership. Okay, so when the partner becomes insane or unsound mind, okay, who is a person? Sound mind means he is in the full state, okay, his concentration is there, he is fully paying attention to the particular business. Unsound mind means he is not in the sense to enter into the partnership. So partner becomes insane or unsound mind. Now when a partner not being a sleeping partner, okay, sleeping partner is not involved, okay, in this particular case, and temporary sickness is also not involved in the dissolution of the firm. So when a partner, okay, in bracket it is mentioned, not a sleeping partner, other partners like nominal partner, active partner, then minor partner, okay, etc., etc. So when a partner has become of unsound mind, okay, has become unsound mind means stupid, idiot, or mentally retired, okay, so the court may dissolve the firm on the suit of the other partners, okay, on the suit of other partners or by the friend of insane partner. Now when the partners, okay, when one partner, okay, there are three partners, x, y, z, and if x becomes unsound mind, then other two partner, y and z, okay, they can go in the court, they can apply in the court that one of our partner is insane, one of our partner is unsound mind, and we want to dissolve the firm. Then court can give the order to end the partnership, okay, or by the friend of insane partner, means if insane means idiot or stupid partner, his friend can apply in the court, okay. Now there is temporary sickness, okay, temporary sickness is no ground for dissolution, okay. Suppose if a partner ABC and if B is not well, or if B is sometimes he is mentally ill or something, and he is going under to some treatment, and if after the following treatment, if he completes his treatment and he is fit and fine, then in that case the firm cannot be dissolved, okay. So a sleeping partner and a temporary sickness, in that case the dissolution of firm is not happened, okay. The court cannot give the permission to dissolve the firm. Clear? Next is permanent incapability, okay. Permanent incapability means if a partner is physically handicapped, physically ill, okay, if he does not have hands and legs to do the business, then partners can apply to the court for dissolution of the firm, okay. Permanent incapacity, if a partner becomes permanently incapable, okay, permanently incapable of performing his duties, as a partner, and other partners, means if a one partner, okay, suppose A, B and C, okay, C is physically handicapped, he is not able to do his work in the partnership, then the other partners A and B can file a suit in the court. Then court means the remaining partner, means A and B, can file a suit in the court to dissolve the partnership. Then court may dissolve the firm, okay. Then now this incapacity may arise from physical disability, okay, physical disability, illness, etc. If partner is physically handicapped and he cannot perform his duty, then other remaining partners can apply in the court for the dissolution of the partnership, and court may give the order to dissolve the firm, okay. So next is misconduct, okay. Misconduct means what? When a partnership is guilty of conduct which is likely to affect prejudicially carrying on of business, and the other partners file a suit in the court, then the court may dissolve the firm. Now if any one partner of the partnership, if he is found guilty, okay, of some conduct, means if he has killed someone, if he has murdered someone and he is found guilty, then the other remaining partners can file a case in the court, and they can dissolve, means court can give the order to dissolve the firm, okay. Because of one partner, if other partners are suffering, then the other partners can apply, can file a suit in the court, and court can give order to dissolve the firm. Next is persistent breach of agreement. Now persistent breach of agreement means, breach means to break. Now there are some authorities given to all the partners, means there are some rules and regulations the partner should follow in the partnership, and if any one partner is persistently breaking those rules, okay, breaking that authority, if he or she is not following that rules and regulation, then in that case he is breaking the agreement, and the firm can means other remaining partner can file a case in the court, and court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Okay, so in the partnership, okay, all the partners are given some particular duties, particular responsibilities which they have to perform, and if any one partner is breaking those rules and regulations, okay, if continuously, if they are persistently means continuously they are breaking the rules and regulation, and because of that breaking misconduct of that partner, other partners as well as the business is facing some problem, then the other partners can file a suit in the court, and then court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Okay, a partner may willingly, okay, may do it by willingly or precedently commit a breach of agreement, relating to what, okay, relating to the management of affair of the firm, means rules and regulations, a reasonable conduct of his business, or conduct himself in manner relating to the business that is not reasonably practicable for other partners to carry on the business in the partnership with them. Okay, in that case, the it can be, means the agreement is breaking, okay, it is breaching the agreement. Okay, so in such cases, in this case, in such cases, the other partners, okay, if any one partner is committing this mistake continuously, and because of that the other partners are suffering, then other partners may file a suit against him in the court, and the court may order to dissolve the firm. Okay, now there are some categories, okay, there are some acts, like the following acts, these are some acts or these are some categories that can follow in the breach of agreement. Okay, now these are there only, like misconduct of management, who is breaking the rules and regulations all the time, they are breaking the agreement. Now there are some acts which can fall in the category of breach of agreement, like embezzlement means robbing, theft. If any one partner is robbing some cash from the partnership firm, then he or she is breaking the agreement. Okay, then keeping error means accounts, not keeping the accounts, books of account properly. Okay, if the partner is not keeping the books of account, he is breaching the agreement. Then holding more cash than allowed. If all the partners are allowed to only hold 1 lakh cash, okay, but if another partner is holding more than 1 lakh, like 2 lakh rupees, 5 lakh rupees, then it is against the agreement, means he is breaking the rules. Then refuse to show accounts despite repeatedly requested. Okay, if other partners, okay, like three partners and one partner is refusing to show the books of account, and other partners are repeatedly asking to show him the books of account, and in that case he is breaking the contract. And other partners, if they find that they are having problem or they are facing the problem, other remaining partners can file a case, can file a suit against him in the court, and court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Next is transfer of interest. Now transfer of interest is what? A partner may transfer all his interest in the firm to the third party, or allow the court to sell, or allow the court to charge or sell his shares in the recovery of areas of land revenue. Now if other partners file a suit against him in the court, then the court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Now transfer of interest, like if any one partner, okay, if he is transferring his interest or shares, okay, to the third party who is not a part of the partnership, देन इफ अदर पार्टनर्स फाइंड दैट द पर्टिकुलर पार्टनर इज शेयरिंग सम इंटरेस्ट ट्रांसफरिंग द इंटरेस्ट ट्रांसफरिंग द शेयर्स टू द थर्ड पार्टी देन द रिमेनिंग पार्टनर कैन फाइल अ सूट अगेंस्ट हिम इन द कोर्ट एंड द कोर्ट मे गिव द ऑर्डर टू रिकवर ऑल द areas which the partner has shared to the third party and give to the remaining partners and they can give the order to dissolve the firm. Next is continuous or next like dissolution of by of the firm by court can happen because of continuous or perpetual losses. Okay. If a firm is running under losses, okay, if a firm is continuously running under losses and the court believes that the business of the firm cannot be carried on without a loss in future too, it may dissolve the firm. Okay, if the court is finding that a firm is continuously running under the losses, perpetual losses, suddenly it is giving profit, suddenly it is giving losses, then and court believes that the firm cannot carry the business in future, in that case the court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Next is just and equitable grounds. Just and equitable ground means the court may find other just and equitable ground for dissolution of the firm. Some such grounds are as follow. Now court may find, okay, if court finds that the particular partnership amongst the partners there is mistrust, there is fight between the partners, okay, that is what fight between the partners, not the partners are not talking with each other regarding the business, then that comes under the just and equitable grounds. Okay, so if court finds that there is mistrust, mismatch of means the relationship between the partners are not properly, then the court may give the order to dissolve the firm. Like deadlock in the partners means partners not being in talking terms with each other, means there is fight between the partners, there the partners are not sharing any information with each other or not willing to share the information with each other, then that will come under just and equitable ground. Okay, next is loss of substantum, means the foundation of the business. Now why the means what is the object, okay, like for what purpose the partners had come together to form the partnership, if that objective or if that motive is missing, okay, if that motive is not there in the partner in the partnership, then it is loss of stratum. Then gambling by a partner on the stock exchange. If one partner is doing some gambling in the stock exchange, that is just an equitable ground, and in that cases the court can give order to dissolve the partnership firm. So these are the modes or methods in which the partnership can come to an end, which is modes of dissolution. So I hope you have understood today's session. In today's session, I have explained you what is dissolution of firm and various methods or types or modes of dissolution. The modes of dissolution can happen by compulsory dissolution, by mutual agreement, by notice, by order of court. Okay, so I hope you have understood the session properly. Thank you very much. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, like and share the video, and do not forget to press the bell icon to get the latest notification. Thank you.